to center for Riley Smith in a rink wide feed. Carlson couldn't come up with it. Coyotes trying to poke it out of the zone. He'll get it outside. Delayed call. And now.
This is big.
Yeah, that's huge. They're offside. Faceoff comes out.
Yeah, and Carlson, that's a frustrated Carlson. He wanted to pick that puck up in full gallop, and he overskated it. And the puck was dumped in offside. If the Coyotes can win this faceoff and get this puck down the ice, empty net as well.
Not like the Coyotes are not pushing off of that. 31, that's still pretty good for the Coyotes standard.
The Golden Knights, Boyd, and the Golden Knights win the draw.
Ball for Swamper. This game so far.
Look at that, Blackhawks 8-5 against the Devils. There are two hat tricks in that game. Jaren Zagov and. Brendan Hago and Patrick Kane. Oh, Bo Beek save there. Fling it. Oh, wide. Bingo. It looks like it's going to be the same score like it was Tuesday night against the Stars.
It's a real nice play in the corner, a little backhand. Cheeky little pass to Schmaltz, who puts it in the back of the net, and that's a monster goal. And look at the save zone before this. Scott Wedgwood, not one, but two. Big stops. Oh, the old behind the legs. Between the legs play, here's the play I was talking about. A little chip play to himself, backhander to Smolson. He just tucks it in the back of the net. That is a big goal.
Another 50 bucks.
This pressure.
Nick Smoltz gets his 11th, second of the game.
Nick Smoltz.
On the assist. 12 seconds to go. The Coyotes are going to defeat the Golden Knights here tonight at Gila River Arena. Big scrum. Play back out high by Amadio. A shot over the top. And just 0.2 seconds remain in this one.
Wow, what a hockey game. This is a gutsy performance. A lot of people around the league would have had the Vegas Golden Knights with the W in this one. But the Coyotes, they just don't go away. And they have shown. There's another look at the play.
But a lot of fans. I think a lot of fans were picking the Golden Knights. Yeah. Well, they bet on that. They lost.
He was absolutely outstanding.
Absolutely gross is what he was. And you gotta think he might get to start again on Sunday. That'll make it 4 in a row. But how about 3 unanswered by this Coyotes group?
Oh, yeah.
They're a group that just doesn't go away. And they showed once again here tonight they can play with absolutely anybody.
So, Tony, at the top of the broadcast tonight, we talked about Clayton Keller and Nick Schmaltz. Keller set up the empty netter for Schmaltz, and how is Schmaltz tonight? How about 2 in the third period to pretty much put this one away?
Yeah, that's what you call foreshadowing, nailing it in the pregame, because certainly they worked together to seal the deal on that empty net goal. Great job by Keller and Schmaltz, and yes, Schmaltz continuing to rack up the points here with those 2 goals tonight. 3-1 victory over the Vegas Golden Knights, and again, Scott Wedgwood was outstanding. Early in this game, 16 saves in that first period to keep it scoreless, and then again late, I would say the last 5.5 minutes of that period, you saw the Vegas Golden Knights having some point-blank shots, and he was there. So unbelievable job once again, 43 saves for Scott Wedgwood. And the Coyotes now, we're seeing 3 straight games now where they've played well. 2 of them were victories, and just a much better brand of hockey of late. Time now for our Gila River Resorts and Casinos 3 stars.
Nick Schmaltz!
And tonight's first star!
First star!
3 big saves on the night from your Coyotes! Number 31, Scott Wedgwood!
Scott Wedgwood! 44 save. No, 43 save.
The first star of the game. We mentioned Schmaltz with the two goals. Gostisbehere with his ninth of the season and 250th career point. But there were a lot of other heroes in this one. Dyson Mayo signing a three-year deal earlier today with the Coyotes. He played outstanding. Liam O'Brien was all over the place. He left the ice a little bit early, but we'll hopefully know more in a bit. But right now, let's get down to ice level and Todd Walsh. Todd?
Jody, thank you very much. I believe goaltender Scott Wedgwood joins us now from the bench after the first star announcement. Scott, I know you well enough, I think. You're never going to admit to being into one of those proverbial goalie zones. But early on, a couple of big PKs by your group. You were the last line of defense. Did that get the juices flowing for you here tonight?
Yeah, I think it's, you know, nice to kind of get into it early. Unfortunately, you know, you don't really want to be down a man, but, you know, it builds a little bit of confidence in that group. You know, the PK group works hard, and, you know, for us to kind of fight them off early, gain a little bit of confidence in our defensive structure, and then, you know, put together a very well-rounded game. I mean, the shot count was high, but once again, the guys did a great job in front of me. A couple of big blocks on the backside. Strawley a couple nights ago. I had Mayo again tonight. And, you know, it's just, it's a do-or-die effort. And, you know, we, as a goalie, really appreciate it.
Speaking of that structure of the game, how big was it for you between the net, the pipes, I should say, that your group was all in on trying to eliminate the exchanging of rushes here tonight to make sure it wasn't a shootout with Vegas?
Yeah, I think, you know, we talked about it before the game, and in the second we got a little bit away from it a few times, just kind of, you know, trade in, and then late in the first too. But, you know, we did a great job picking up rushes. I mean, we've done a better job as of late communicating. I think that's the big thing the guys really, you know, taking ownership on, is communicating who they're taking on the way back. You know, as a goalie, I'm trying to talk, but once everyone's kind of covered, there's not too many options for the opposing team, and that really makes my life a lot easier.
One last question, if I could, before I let you go. We just did a story about something you said to us recently about your goaltending coach, Corey Schwab. He's been there and done that. He was a backup for most of his career in the National Hockey League, and that you guys speak the same language. How big is that relationship as you navigate the waters of your career that puts you to this point right now as a starter, essentially, here?
Oh, he's awesome. It's been fun. I mean, you pick his brain. He's, like you said, he's gone through it. And, you know, at times there, Veggie's been playing great. And, you know, one week he came up to me and said, hey, you've been through it. We got to work. We got to go with, you know, back to work every day. And once you get back in there, be ready. And then, you know, same story right now. I've played a couple in a row here. Veggie's going to work. You know, he came off morning skate this morning, you know, bagged. And it's hard work behind the scenes. You know, a lot of people don't see that. But, you know, leaning on him, and then, you know, the conversations I've had with, you know, Veg, you know, when he was here, and Schwab, you've honestly played dividends for kind of what I've been doing as of late.
Scott, it's always a pleasure to talk to you and a pleasure to watch you play the game, especially on a night like tonight. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Walsh.
All right, Scott Wedgwood here from Gila River Arena on this Friday night. Our coverage continues here on Valley Sports. When we come back, Coyotes Live, the postgame show, will...